Saviva can live with your constant glowing, but not your constant talking.
What sort of Khajiit doesn't want to carry his ancestors' ashes around? Your great-great-great-grandmother spent a lot of gold on this urn, you know.
Sisfo, the constant nagging and judging and glowing and floating. This is why Saviva avoids his family at all costs, especially the undead ones. My shiny ancestor here. We got along fine when he was ashes in an urn, but something stirred his spirit, and now he won't leave me alone. He says Saviva spends too much time drinking and napping, as if there's something better to spend time on. Saviva threw a big party. Everyone was having fun until a jeek bumped the urn and woke my ancestor from the dead. Now, Saviva needs to get the urn to our family tomb so he can rest. But warring cultists are blocking the way. You will help, yes? Fragrant, gather the urn and take it to our family tomb. Saviva usually avoids these crypts because of all the stairs and murderous spirits, so he doesn't know exactly which tomb is ours. But he's marked the location on your map. They're fighting over territory around Rimmen. These shaveskins are always fighting over something, yes? Screaming, then fighting, then screaming while fighting, then dying, then screaming about someone dying. Too much drama for Saviva.
Thank you. Rajin was there when the city was still Rimka, before the influence of men. To steal a city, this is easy. To take its name, not even this one could accomplish such a feat.
Thank you.
mind me to ask Saviwa why these two urns are so much bigger than mine? Jorari appreciates your efforts, but this is not where he belongs. We should keep moving before the cultists find other uses for my urn. Yes, but Jorari belongs to a larger family, one that shares more than blood. Bring Jorari's urn to another tomb. Joan and Jode will light our path. Jorari remembers visiting this tomb with his brother once. This is much closer to Jorari's resting place, but not quite right. We will know we are there when we find the shining guards. The light of the moons may lead us astray, but in the end, it always shows us what we need to see. the place for Jorari to rest. I have never been more certain of anything in my entire death. Finally, a tomb fit for a car. Ah, thank you. Jorari can finally rest next to his beloved queen. If Saviwa listened, he would have learned that Jorari once led this nation, and if he would have taken me to my resting place, Jorari would have led him to our forgotten treasury. Please, put my urn with the others, friend. I want to see my queen. I'm sure Saviwa will be pleased to know that I won't be bothering him any longer. Jorari hopes that Saviwa is a little bothered by the fact that he missed out on our royal treasure.
Defiled this sacred resting place!
Ah!
Saviva just woke up from his best nap in weeks. You got rid of that nagging Jeet, didn't you? Did you decide to just kick his urn off a cliff? Saviva won't tell anyone if you just decided to kick his urn off a cliff. The old ghost was royalty. If Saviva had that treasure, he would never have to work a day in his life. Oh well, Saviva will find another way to be lazy. Take this for your efforts. It's no royal treasure, but it's the best Saviva has to give. Saviva wishes he had his ancestors' treasure. He could have thrown his best party in ages. There would have been nice wine, lots of ladies, weird smooth skins juggling sharp objects. Ah, it would have been good times, my friend. Very good times. Saviva is thinking about having some drinks, then taking some naps. After that, maybe more drinks and more naps, but in no particular order. That's sort of Saviwa's thing.